All right, our first competitor coming to us from Blackpool, England, weighing in at 110 pounds and screaming at quite a few decibels, is Sarah Clayton. Oh, and it looks like I'm being joined by the one and only Blaze Cameron.
Happy to be here, happy to be here.
Alright, looks like our next competitor, coming to us from Bushwick, Brooklyn, New York, weighing at 125 pounds, Candy Perez. This is Candy's second match in BCW. She debuted last week.
Now help me out here, Dante. How can someone who's clearly obsessed with Candy be in such good shape?
Well, that's a great question. Yeah. We'll ask her that later, but I do know one thing. Candy is actually interested in powerlifting. So, don't let the name fool you.
Hey, nothing wrong with a lady who's got a bit of fitness going for her.
See, and you also just recently came here to BCW, didn't you, Mr. Cameron?
That's absolutely correct, Mr. Nalmova. I'm brand new here to this area, and anxious to get started. But right now, let's go ringside.
All right, looks like Aaron is checking to see both competitors are ready to go. It takes Aaron a minute. He doesn't have that many brain cells left.
Harsh.
Yeah, Sarah screams a lot. Nobody knows why. What? Who's nasty to referees? I am a bastion of kindness to Aaron. I even let him wash my car for me.
Oh, what is this? Someone's taking the initiative here.
Well, I never said I was gonna pay you, Aaron. Hey, we're all mixed up in the corner with some big chops.
Sarah Clayton wasting absolutely no time going to work.
Sarah might be small, but she is definitely one of the more vicious competitors on BCW.
Yeah, she has some experience under her belt, doesn't she?
She does. She is a veteran here in the ring. Meanwhile, Candy's still kind of a rookie. As I said, only her second match in BCW.
But she's got some moves with that evasive back roll there.
Oh, definitely. Candy is, Candy's very strong, but she's also extremely agile.
I don't know if Sarah's going to be able to keep up with that.
Candy trying to take out Sarah's legs with a series of nasty kicks and a big standing drop kick.
She's going to be feeling that in the morning.
Shoot, she's feeling it right now. Wait a minute, where's Candy going? There she goes. Climbing onto the apron.
That's never a good position for the opponent.
Alright, Aaron said get off the apron, and she did. Now she's balanced up on the top rope. That takes some skill to stay up there.
Strength and agility. It's looking like Candy here is the whole package.
She is, and there's a diving crossbody.
Could it be over this quick?
I doubt Sarah would allow it to be end this quickly. She'd be screaming for days. Not that she doesn't do that already.
I was about to say, we got an earful of that just a moment ago.
It's a good thing I'm half deaf already.
Well, give me till the end of the night and you'll be fully deaf.
Huh?
Exactly.
And then it's like Sarah's starting to take charge of this match, throwing Candy down and just walloping her in the face.
Well, and now Candy's not taking that line down.
Nope. Countering with the old Luthez press, and now, oh boy.
Just a straight up power struggle.
Yeah, this has descended more into a brawl than a fight now.
I feel like that's going to play more into Candy's strengths, though.
A ground-based match like that, where power means more, definitely. Aaron telling one of them to watch the hair. It's hard to tell who he's talking to in that mass of arms and legs. Oh, and Sarah just gets absolutely smashed into the corner. Candy definitely throwing her weight around.
Oh! Not a welcoming presence.
Yep, and there's that ring awareness that Sarah has as
that
a veteran.
That comes with experience, yeah.
Definitely. Candy will learn. Hopefully. I've seen some veterans that barely seem to have any ring awareness. And there goes Sarah with a pin. Still only a one.
Denied.
Shows you how resilient Candy is.
Well, she's coming in strong, and she's not willing to go out without a fight, apparently. And she's just stomping away at her. And an elbow. Candy looks like she's trying to weather it, but... And
a nasty
leg drop.
That was nasty. Right across the neck. I imagine you've probably been on the receiving end of a couple of those, being a wrestler yourself. There's a pin.
Yeah.
Just a two count.
They're not pleasant, but Candy remains resilient.
Now Sarah's just tossing Candy all over the place. Let's see if Candy can somehow get control. And there she goes, ducking underneath that clothesline. Back off the ropes.
Well, she's working something up.
A double clothesline.
Oh. I guess it's coming down to who's going to get up first.
Yep, whoever gets up first is definitely going to have the advantage. Aaron starting his 10 count.
Both looking a bit spent here.
Looks like Sarah's the first one back to her feet, and she goes right after Candy again.
Oh!
And screaming it. Oh, and the scream is met with a punch to the face.
That feels like an appropriate response.
It generally is.
Oh! Candy, no mercy.
Candy with a big kick to Sarah's gut.
And that swinging neck breaker. Sarah's got to be feeling that dread now.
Don't let it set in. Don't let it.
Looks like Candy's prepping something big. I am so ready.
She calls this the double fudge handspring. Wow, backflips all the way across the ring and then driving that big elbow right into Sarah's head.
Oof. I'm amazed she can even stand after that.
Oh, and here's Candy with another signature move, the Twizzler Stretch.
Now that's going to be hyper-extending the arms there. And that scream might be justified.
I think it is. That looks like a hard pin to get, a hard stretch to get out of.
Oh, and it just gets worse.
And still only a two count. That goes to show you how resilient Sarah is in this match.
No kidding. But that's what experience will do for you, I guess. It toughens you up.
As much as I like watching Candy wrestle, these high energy, high impact moves, how long can she actually keep that up?
She's got to be gassing out.
Oh! Another one of those rookie mistakes. Took a little too long playing to the crowd.
And nobody home.
Yep. I believe off the rope moonsault, Candy calls that her fun dip moonsault. There wasn't nothing fun about that, though.
Nope. Oh, she's going upstairs.
Yeah. I think in contrast to Candy, Sarah's kind of a no-nonsense, straightforward fighter.
I gotta appreciate someone who knows to appreciate the crowd.
Oh, and there goes Candy down, both feet right in the face.
Jesus. On the same token, I gotta appreciate someone who can bring the pain, too. Oh, but she kicks out.
Both these women are showing a lot of resilience right now.
Tell me about Candy's last performance. Was that a victory for her?
I believe it was. My memory is generally terrible. But yes.
Fair enough. Because it looks like she's desperate to win this one.
Yes, Casey remembers more than me because, well, he records all this stuff. So, yes, Candy did win at her premiere last week here at BCW.
But it looks like she's attempting to make an impression here today. Oh, and this could be it.
With the lollipop drop. One, a two, and a three.
That's it, everyone.
And you have your winner by pinfall, Candy Perez.
And man, did she earn it.
Well, looks like she gave something, Sarah something to scream about now.
If she's even conscious. Oh, no, there she is.
Y'all the picture. Fox can paw just quiet like a whisper.
Big congratulations to Candy. Sister, not bad, mean, bad, you definitely earned bad, mean, good.
Damn, I'm so good. But, Candy definitely has a bright future BCW if she keeps up performances like this.
She keeps up this momentum, she may have more than just a bright future.
Oh, yes. Eventually, she might face down our new women's champion, Miss Emma Gray, who won the women's title last week.
So that the press might bend. Now, how bad you want to know if I'm sweeter than candy?